Tonight is the second installment of the IRC's international documentary film series happening at Balboa Park. And here to tell us more about it is Donna Duven. She is the executive director of the IRC, which is the International Rescue Committee. Welcome.
Thank you for inviting me.
So what can you tell us about tonight's event?
Well, it's a celebration of our 11th anniversary film series, which I'm really happy to bring to the audience. It brings a unique perspective from around the globe that really features the refugee experience. And the idea is to bring the conversation to the audience in a way that they have a chance to experience that for themselves, to raise pertinent questions that they may have about the refugee experience and form their own opinions.
And I understand that these three films are separate, but are there any uniting themes that are repeated?
Well, I think the thing we really want to bring home to the audience is that people don't flee their home and loved ones and great memories by choice. They flee because they have no choice. It's because of violence and persecution that they leave everything behind. And it's a torturous journey that they undertake, oftentimes with women and children in tow. And we want them to understand what fortitude, what resilience, and what courage it takes for people to make that choice.
And how does this film series fit into the IRC's overall goal?
Well, we've been fortunate to be doing this work in San Diego for over 40 years, which means we were at the very forefront of receiving refugee families back in the 1970s. And so every day since then, we've had the opportunity and the privilege of welcoming refugee families into San Diego to provide them with a brand new beginning. And tonight's film is especially meaningful for me. I really love this film. Because it depicts 35 Syrian women who come together in a Lebanese refugee camp, who are introduced to the experience of theater, and they have a chance to not only play and dream, but also to find their own voices. And for many of the families that we resettled here in San Diego, especially back in 2016, that included many Syrian families.
And how has the resettlement process here in San Diego changed under the Trump administration?
Well, it's definitely a slower pace than what we had seen in earlier years. The administration actually dropped the ceiling for the number of refugees that they would allow into the country from 75,000 in earlier years to 30,000 for this year. And so right now our real goal is to make sure that every last family that's able to be received in the U.S. has that opportunity to find safety.
So yesterday, lawmakers met at the White House, and it's making news that the conversation included reform for legal immigration. Mm-hmm. Any concerns about changes to the legal immigration process and how that might impact refugees and asylum seekers?
I think anytime we talk about welcoming the foreign-born, I think, you know, we start to put an emphasis on what value they bring to the country, and we start to evaluate that. With refugees and with asylum seekers, they are brought to our borders because they're fleeing violence and persecution, which means that they are sometimes the most vulnerable families that are out there. So we'd hope that we would be able to change the dialogue, not just about what families can bring to us, but what they can contribute once they're here if given the right opportunity.
And getting back to tonight's film series, what do you hope that people who attend come away from the theater with?
I think I want them to see the heart and just the conviction of people who are seeking a new opportunity. The women that are depicted in tonight's film are women who have oftentimes been contained in terms of their opportunities to be empowered to have careers or seek an education. And when they're given that opportunity, even sometimes through a refugee camp, to have education for the first time, or if they come to another country and seek education or empowerment and freedoms, you see individuals who have been under threat of violence, who are coming to life for the very first time and finding their voices. And it's such an uplifting opportunity to be a part of, and that's what we have a chance to experience day in and day out here in San Diego.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
And for more information about the IRC's international documentary film series happening tonight, go to kpbs.org.